Why you bring that money to the club if you ain't throwing it? How you make it on the ground but in person you ain't showing it? Why you go against the game, you can't beat them, join it. Ain't tapping when you got the Cali, got your started. Brand new coupe, I floor it. Brand new, got a brand new Glock, I adore it. Have it running like Forrest. VIP, I'm very important.
That's the look I'm seeing with the NBA players.
Yeah.
The athletes are going more flair these days.
What I feel is the flair is going to have a shelf life of roughly around a year. And then the next movement that I'm forecasting is the very relaxed fit.
How do you figure that out? How do you
it's a cycle.
Something, so you guys just know how long it...
And plus, I tend to focus on the youth a lot more. As in the up-and-coming teenagers from the ages of 12 to the 16-year-olds. And when I'm out in public and stuff like that, I see what they wear and how they do it. And I noticed that this next generation, they're tapping into how we were in the 90s, where we couldn't afford the nice stuff, but we can by adding our flair to it,
mm-hmm.
by cutting our pants, opening them ourselves.
Are you foreseeing almost like that Jenko look, that old school?
Yes, but not there yet. The 90s vintage, thrifting, getting, orange tab Levi's, and then, wearing girls wear high-waisted, guys just naturally like to wear a base point will be the white Air Force Ones. As long as it sits over the shoe, that's what they're looking for. They're very relaxed now.
So, in your opinion, that white Air Force One is like some timeless.
Yes. For the next generation.
Okay.
Well, what we had back then with the Reebok Classics and the Cortez, mm-hmm. I'm from the Orange County, LA area.
Yeah.
So the Cortez is the Reebok Classic and stuff is what my era was.
Yes.
But now their era is the white, powdered white Air Force
One. Gotcha. We're from the same era.
I'm
right there with you.
Yeah.
One more question before we get into some of your new stuff.
Okay.
Just because you're spitting some educational stuff right now. I'm learning a little bit. How did you guys foresee the shelf life of the skinny pants, the skinny jeans? Is that still gonna last?
That's still gonna last. It's still gonna be that clientele that wants it, but it's percentage-wise, 100%. It's gonna shift from 60 to 70, almost to 90, and now it's going back down to the 60, going to the 40.
Okay.
And I'm forecasting, and I'm seeing a lot of big retailers actually stop buying skinny jeans now.
Okay.
So, seeing that we're on the same page, let's talk about what we're gonna do in the future and get ready for it.
What about the regular form fitting? Where's that at?
That's gonna be a staple.
That should be the staple.
Kind of
makes sense.
Yes, because then we made our standard cargo pants.
Okay.
Regular fit, straight leg, not too big, very tapered, natural, typical ripstop army cargo pants.
Okay, gotcha.
And that goes back to the Air Force One.
Yeah, how it sits on the Air Force One.
And I know that's gonna be a staple in our collection throughout the years, so we're gonna keep it like that. The West Coast will adapt towards the really relaxed fit. But everyone else, I'm talking about the Midwest to the South, they'll be on the flare still.
Okay.
But then West Coast always leads. I'm not trying to be biased because I'm from the
West Coast. But if then I could throw up the W right now, I would.
You know what I mean? But then we kind of set the tone. And if it sticks, it's going to stick and it's going to trickle down to the South and the East Coast.
All the knowledge you're kicking with us right now. Let's talk about some of your pieces that you guys brought here. What we got?
We're working on denim. We've been working on it for over 3 years. Our pricing has to be at a certain criteria, and I feel like right now is a good time for us to show. So basically, we have a flare.
Yep.
Flare print with the raw edge hem on the bottom. With the carpenter style panel, but it's bleached to have that look with a little bit of pink splatter,
mm-hmm.
With a lot of stretch to the denim.
Got it.
It's gonna be that basic look that's in right now at the moment.
So this is all dope, this is fire. Talk to me about how you find the way to blend top quality but affordable.
A lot of searching, a lot of development, a lot working with the different factories, mm-hmm. to try to nail down what you want when it comes to fabric, material, dyes,
mm-hmm.
treatments, and cost of landing on the goods and everything else.
Okay.
That all comes into play. With the whole COVID thing, everything has gone up in pricing, but still we don't want to jeopardize our pricing because we want to make it very affordable.
Yeah.
And it's been a long process. Yeah, so what's in right now is very military. Anything camouflage from desert camo, hunter camo, traditional camo, it's in right now.
Okay.
And on top of that, a lot of people like pink splatters and stuff like that too, but we wanted to do it very subtle and stuff like that, not too aggressive, where we actually made this. This has actually been made for years.
Yeah.
It's just something that's in right now at mm-hmm. the moment. So, yeah, so it's typical cargo.
Got
a little bit of pink splatter. And just the play on the whole right now, the carpenter, hardware working guys pants is in right now. So we actually had our own version right here.
Right.
With the panel right here, but we actually did something different. We put a little twist on it because cargo pants are training so hard, we actually put a cargo flap over the panel.
Got it.
So we infused 2-in-1.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Something different.
Genius.
Something different.
Genius. Yeah. So yeah, you're always bringing something different.
Thank
Talk to us some about some of the female pieces that we
well,
can see.
Well, basically,
is there any other female?
The
females rocking some of the.
We don't broadcast it, but we actually have been making extra small on up to 2XL, so it's universal, but we don't want to throw it out there like, hey, I'm gonna force this on women. No, it's naturally, after COVID, everyone's very lax on their styling and stuff now, more comfortable. So now they're just infusing what they're used to wearing during COVID into their day-to-day outfits, attire when they go out at night.
So the sizing is almost unisex.
Yes.
Okay, so as long as they find their size, mm-hmm. male or female can be rocking
it fits,
any of this.
It fits,
okay.
Like, unless you're like a really petite kind of person.
Yeah.
Sweatpants all day long, but our nylon cargo pants and stuff like that too, I mean, they love it.
Show me something that you know the females love. This is for the females right here.
So this is basically one of our best selling for females is our PH
cargo
pants.
Yeah, those are dope, yes.
With the side buns on the side.
Oh,
and women love it. And plus it's a drawstring, so I can actually have it around the waist really tight.
Got
accents it. Their body really well on certain things. But then this thing just trickled onto everything that we've been making for women.
And that goes on some, that's on some comfy, but still fashionable.
Active. High-end active fashion, I guess you can say.
High-end active
fashion.
Okay.
I guess that's what you can say. But yeah, I have some new stuff that we've been working on also. This is actually our collab right here with Dave East.
Okay.
We have a whole collection with him right now that we're working on. We're going to drop it sometime in March, I believe.
Yeah, he's repping the West, right?
He's from Harlem originally,
okay.
You know, he has a very good West Coast influence in his styling and stuff like that,
okay.
Too.
Okay, yeah, that's
so
what I thought.
We actually been collaborating with him early on in his career for the last, I think our first collaboration with him, we made track pants for him, was like 8 years ago, I believe.
Okay.
So we invested in him as solely organically, just like loving what he's doing.
We appreciate you taking the time with the drop. My man Boyd with EPTM.
I'm the creative director.
Creative
for the
director.
Last 3 years.
Okay, yeah. Gotcha. Well, you guys are doing a hell of a job.
Thank you so
and
much.
I know your brand is one of the favorites on the drop. So keep it up, man. We're gonna keep on representing you. And I know I'm gonna keep on rocking the stuff I got.
We appreciate all you guys' support
yes, sir.
Right, the drop.
Yes, sir.
Thank you guys.